was I? Oh, yeah. After we left, after I left Tom's house, I took the back roads to the interstate. You see the route right there. So I'm on the way to Indianapolis. So I decided to go back home the quickest route possible. Because, number one, I just want to go ahead and get home. But number two, I wear these over-the-ankle work shoes, steel-toed work boots, which are waterproof. So, when we came up to spend the night at Motel 6, at the Holiday Inn Express, I noticed my right foot, was starting to, with the lack of a better word, jungle rot or trench foot, and the skin on my foot was being irritated and just becoming red and sweaty, and I don't want to go into the really gross details, but it was getting really bad. So that sort of put a damper. It wasn't painful, but it wasn't good. It was really bad, to be honest. I don't want to show you any pictures or anything. So actually tomorrow, which is Monday, I had to take another flex day because I'm going to go see a podiatrist. I've had this once before, and about 5 years ago. And it's like athlete's foot on steroids. So I'm going to go see a podiatrist tomorrow and get this thing squared away. But I think for riding for that long a time and sweating in those boots, because they're waterproof, so they're not breathable. And that really aggravated this condition to the extreme of having to see a doctor. But anywho, I left Tom's house and went a few, my buddy Mark, he has done this route many, many times, so he's showing me to try to get stay away from I-75 because it's so busy. So he took me to 39 and then to 69 and then to 65. So I'm just flying solo now, coming back from Michigan. And so when I get tired, I stop. When I have to go pee, I go pee, or get a fuel stop, or get a bite to eat, take a break, whatever. So I'm making fairly good time until I get close to Indianapolis. So my buddy BC69525, shout out to you, lives near Indianapolis. So he told me just to, because of that late in the day, he told me just to go straight down 69, right into Indianapolis, and take the 465 bypass on around to the nearest Motel 6. Well, I guess about 10 miles from that loop around, it's starting to cloud up. And I checked the radar, and yes, I'm probably going to be running into some rain. So I pull over at a gas station and put my rain gear on. So I start going into Indianapolis, and it's not bad. It's light rain and stuff. So I'm saying to myself, well, this is good. I should have just left this stuff off. Well, when I hit the 465 loop, that's when it all broke loose. Had torrential rain, pea-sized hail, lightning strikes all over the place. And I've never ridden in the storms this severe. And little did I know there was a tornado warning near where I was. I don't know if it ever touched down. It might have just been indicated by Doppler radar. But it was a, shall we say, a unique experience. But the one good thing about that was it was so hard, everybody was slowing down. I think they had a wreck on 465. And so it pretty much brought it down to one lane. So it wasn't, I could see in front of me, see the taillights in front of me, and that was about it until I got to the exit that I needed to get off on. But for those that you, those that is watching this and have not went to a torrential downpour, well, you're in for a treat. So yeah, so I finally get to my room at Motel 6, and when I get there, I get a call from BC, make sure I got there okay, and so I start to get settled in and everything, and so I get a call back. I hadn't taken a shower yet. I got a call back, and they were waiting outside. So I hustled up, took a shower, and doctored my foot up and everything, and went downstairs, and he was generous enough to treat me to dinner at the Philadelphia Philly cheese, Philly steak and fries, I think that's the name of the restaurant, down there by the motel. And I got to meet his lovely wife, Janice. So it was a very good experience there. Had a good time. That was fun, relaxing. Got to wind down a little bit from that harrowing ride in. So I spend the night in Indy. So I get up and he, instead of getting right back on 465, the GPS took me down Michigan Road or Avenue, whichever it was. And like I said, I'm at a leisurely pace now. So I go down there and see the Indiana Fine Arts Museum and stuff like that on the side, just taking in the sights as I'm cruising on down the road a little bit. Then I get back on and hit 65 South. Well, I get on there, and I'm out of Indianapolis, and I go down 65 South, and there is a lot of construction between Indianapolis and Louisville. So I keep on going down to I-65 there. And so I call another Bergman rider of mine, friend of mine, Randy and Paula McLean. They live near the Indiana-Kentucky state line near Louisville, around in that area. And they were gracious enough to meet me at Cracker Barrel with their two fine grandchildren. And we had a brunch thing there because it was so late, because there was a wreck on 65 South. A tractor trailer went out off the road, and so that was backed up forever. But I made it and sat there and had a nice brunch with them and talked to them for a good while. And they were kind enough to give me a new grandpa coffee cup because of my because of our grandchild coming in the next couple of weeks. So I have a good time there. And so, well, it's time to get back on the road, head towards home.